Earlier you learned how to identify how many electrons were in an individual atom given the symbol. For example, if you were given the symbol boron, the B, its atomic number is 5, which means it has 5 protons, which means it also has 5 electrons, as long as it's neutral. Not all 5 of the electrons in boron are important to us when it comes to looking at compounds, taking these atoms and joining them together to form compounds. And so what we want to look at next is how do we identify the electrons that are important to us when it comes to looking at compounds, and how can we draw them? And so we're looking at what's called valence electrons. The valence electrons are the ones that are important to us when it comes to determining compounds, and they are literally the outside electrons. The outside electrons are the ones that are added last, if you will. They are furthest away from the nucleus. They are the ones that participate in chemical bonding, forming compounds. And you can identify how many of these valence electrons each atom has very, very quickly and easily by looking at the group number. When it comes to these main group elements, those are the elements in columns 1A, 2A, 3A, 4A, 5A, 6A, 7A, and 8A, the A group elements. That number with the Roman numeral tells you how many valence electrons there are. So the number of valence electrons equals the group number when I'm talking about the A group elements. It's slightly different for the B group elements, but we won't be handling that in this video. So boron has 3 valence electrons because he's in group 3A. Phosphorus has 5 valence electrons because he's in group 5A. Helium is an exception to this. Helium does not have 8 valence electrons because he's in group 8A. Helium only has 2 valence electrons. You might have guessed this anyway. Helium only has 2 electrons to begin with because his atomic number is 2, which means he has 2 total electrons. Helium is kind of like hydrogen in that it's going to be the exception for just about everything we do this semester, and this is an exception. Helium only has 2 valence electrons. But neon, right below it, will have 8 valence electrons. Neon is in group 8A, and all of the rest of the elements in the noble gas column, the noble gas group, argon, krypton, xenon, these will all have 8 valence electrons. So even though they have different total numbers of electrons, they all have 8 valence electrons. Now I can symbolize these valence electrons. Let me get some space here. I can symbolize these valence electrons in something called a dot symbol. The dot symbol puts dots around the letter that stands for the element up to the total number of valence electrons. So let's go back to boron with his 3 valence electrons. I would put 3 dots around the symbol for boron. I would put them in the up and down and left and right positions, and I would keep them in different positions as I moved around boron. Now, I could have put the 3 dots in these positions, and that is perfectly acceptable, or I could have put the 3 dots in these positions, and again, that's perfectly acceptable. The thing is I have to have those 3 dots in one of each one of the 4 positions around it in the up, down, left, right position, and they have to be in different positions. For carbon, carbon is in group 4A, so he has 4 valence electrons, so I will symbolize the dot symbol for carbon by putting 4 dots around it in all of the up, down, left, right positions. If it comes to nitrogen, nitrogen is in group 5A, so nitrogen has 5 valence electrons. The first 4 will take up the 4 positions, and now for the 5th one, I have to start doubling up. So this would be the dot symbol for nitrogen. Alternatively, I could have put the dot symbol that looks like this, and then I could have put the 5th one over here and paired it up, or I can put the paired up one to the left, or I could put the paired up one to the bottom. That part doesn't matter as long as I've got all of them spread out as far as I can, and I only start pairing them up when needed, when necessary. For neon, with his 8 valence electrons in group 8A, my first 4 will go in the 4 positions, and then I'll start pairing up. So 5, 6, 7, 8. This would be the dot symbol for neon.